There are several reasons why I think Maryland is a great place for biotech companies. First of all, we've got a significant critical mass now of private sector companies in Maryland. We have a community of entrepreneurs and a developing culture of entrepreneurship here. There's also engaged and enthusiastic support from the public sector. In terms of education and basic research resources, I think we've got one of the best foundations of any place in the country.
The Maryland Biotechnology Center was created really to support those very early stage companies in all aspects of their trying to attract financing, write their business plans, train their workers. Maryland is actually a business-friendly environment, and the state has a series of programs to incentivize companies to move into the state.
Some of the factors we looked at in deciding where to locate included the availability of lab space and office space, as well as the cost. And also the closeness to collaborators and potential partners in federal labs and universities. So when against those criteria, Maryland was a very, very strong candidate.
There are several developments at Glycomimetics that we're particularly excited about. One is that we closed on a venture financing at the end of 2009, which funds us through the completion of this next set of important clinical milestones. Another is that we've achieved fast track status and orphan drug status from the FDA, which gives us special incentives to develop a drug for rare diseases like sickle cell. And finally, we're starting our phase 2 clinical trial now, which is an important milestone in terms of developing efficacy and safety data for our new product.
CCL Biomedical is dedicated to the development and commercialization of novel antimicrobial compounds. One project we're working on right now is actually putting our compounds onto textiles that go into hospitals. The goal is to actually reduce the number of hospital-acquired infections, which are not only costly to treat, but have very high, relatively high mortality rates.
If your idea is still underdeveloped, we can help you write your plan. If you need information on market and its size and describing its characteristics, we have databases that are totally free of charge where we can help you flesh out what is the market opportunity for your new product. From a funding perspective, there is the biotech tax credit where you can attract angel investment into your company. If you mature as a company, we also have the Maryland Venture Fund that can actually make an equity investment in your company as well.
The state was one of our first investors. So when we first set out to raise money for Glycomimetics, we were very happy to be able to attract an investment from the state venture fund. Now since then, we've gone on and we've attracted significant amounts of additional private sector capital. So I think that's actually a great model for what the state is trying to do with the initial investments that they're making in biotech companies.
And in addition to that, if you already need a home for your business, you've matured your idea so that now you're looking for space, we do have a 25 large incubator network system to support you.
The incubators are very important, just because, especially when you're setting up your first company for the first time, you don't know a lot of things, and sometimes you don't know what you don't know. And being able to save time in finding someone who can at least point you in the right direction is crucial. We rely a lot on collaborations and partnerships and consultants as a way to keep our costs down so that we can really focus our money on the research and development activity. And being close to some of the universities, University of Maryland, Johns Hopkins, and we've actually got Aberdeen Proving Ground 10 minutes down the road, that's been invaluable for us, being able to run into these people and network with them, as well as just pop in, when you need to ask someone something.
We have a collaboration, for example, at the NIH. So we are certainly taking advantage of the technical and research resources here in Maryland, but one thing that's important to us is that being here allows us to attract people from elsewhere in the country to come to Maryland to take advantage of what we offer and what the state offers in terms of quality of life.
I think with the BioMaryland 2020 plan, it really crystallizes a strategic plan and the long-term planning that you need to really bring those pieces together and continue some of these innovative funding programs, especially for the smaller companies.
The BioMaryland 2020 strategic plan is really a framework for action. And the fact that the governor has himself stood behind this plan and also energized our legislators to has meant that the funding for life science in Maryland, despite the recession, has been maintained.
When I look back and see the growth that's taken place here in the past 20 years, I think it's very exciting. Maryland will certainly continue to be an exciting place for biotechnology companies to locate and will continue to be one of the most important places to be as a biotechnology center where we'll be developing products, commercializing products, and getting them into the hands of patients and doctors where they can really be of help.